Episode 5, Arizona's Interconnected Water Resources. Did you know that on average, Arizona gets only 9 inches of rain per year? And that we lose an average of 7 times more water to the atmosphere through evaporation than we receive from it? Make no mistake, the rain is very welcomed indeed. But as desperate as we are for it, it is actually groundwater that most of the state depends on. In some ways, it's the most reliable place to store water. Because Arizona's big sun can't reach down to the groundwater, groundwater doesn't evaporate. And all those aquifers we've been talking about serve as giant storage systems for our water supply. Even underground, groundwater is still very much connected to our surface water systems and plays a vital role in our everyday life. In areas where we have surface water, groundwater is often used to supplement our water supply when Arizona faces drought conditions that have been intensified by climate change. For example, the Salt and Verde River watersheds provide water to the Salt River Project System, also known as SRP. The water in that system serves many purposes in the greater Phoenix area, from irrigation to drinking water. And in drought years, when the 6 reservoirs within the system don't fill adequately, guess what we use instead? That's right, groundwater that is drilled for and pumped to the surface. 41% of the water used in Arizona comes from groundwater. In times of shortage on the reservoirs, up to 25 to 30% of SRP's water supply could come from wells they've purchased across the valley. To maintain our underground reserves, aquifers are artificially recharged. This means that we store the excess surface water underground. Have you ever seen what looks like a giant swimming pool out in the desert? These large basins aren't for training Olympians. They are for recharging our aquifers. By recharging water from the Colorado River, we prevent our aquifers from being overdrawn and ensure our future water supply. The Arizona Water Banking Authority and a number of cities have stored over 4 million acre-feet of water. So, there you have it. The management of groundwater is essential. After all, in our arid climate, water evaporates from reservoirs, rivers, and canals, but not from groundwater. For instance, Lake Mead alone, which covers approximately 160,000 acres, loses over 600,000 acre-feet of water to evaporation each year. But to understand how we began to manage our water supply in one of the driest states in the United States, we need to look back to where it all began. How has Arizona managed its water supply? Watch episode 6 for a look back